it comes down to a matter of doing your homework. You got to pick the right designer. If you pick the wrong designer, well, then you have no idea. If you pick somebody that has a stake in the game because they've got this magic product that's going to solve all your problems, and they're just trying to put that in there, then, you know, then you're likely going to have issues later. You need to pick somebody that has a track record, that has the right reputation, and, you know, work with them. Get somebody you trust. And I think you can call any major designer and talk with them and negotiate with them over what you can afford and the scope of what they can provide. Maybe they can't provide a full design, but at least they might can get you headed in the right direction, and they can help you avoid some of the pitfalls that you'll, again, encounter later on. Having the right direction is so important. Knowing what you don't want to do is easily as important as knowing what you want to do. And helping clarify that is something that a good designer can help you do. But, I mean, it is the designer's responsibility to drive the project. That's their job, is to make sure that they're driving the project to the result that you want. Again, that's why I suggested you put so much emphasis on the planning part of this in the beginning, that it's really clear what you want to accomplish and what the metrics for success are. It has to perform appropriately. It has to cost the right amount. It has to be affordable. It has to be built within a reasonable time frame that'll work for your business. I mean, if you miss a key revenue stream because it's built too late, or because you missed your tax incentive or whatever it is, I mean, now you're in failure. So all those things are something that your designer needs to take seriously, take to heart, and they need to help find the balance between those and help make good compromises. But while the designer is responsible for driving the project, their efforts should reflect your goals, reflect your budget, your schedule, and it should be a mirror of your expectations for performance. It should also be a mirror for the quality and for the ultimate result that you're trying to achieve. Again, programming and planning, that's why they're so important. And if you don't feel that your designer has your best interest at heart, you've got the wrong designer. You need to trust them. And if you're sure you got the right guy, then you need to rely on what they have to say. You need to, you know, if they tell you to do something, you know, have them explain it. If they can't explain why they're doing something or why you need to do something, well, then maybe they don't understand it either. But, you know, when they tell you something, you need to rely on that. And their job is to present you with clear options in terms that you can understand, so that you can make good choices and make wise compromises. You know, every project is a series of compromises. Nobody can build it perfectly. There is no such thing as perfect acoustics or a perfect building. They're only appropriate. They're appropriate in that you made the right choices, you spent the money wisely, you spent it where you need to, you've achieved the performance goals you need to, it works the way you need to, it doesn't overperform. You haven't gold-plated one part and left another part, you know, left hanging. And that's what your designer is supposed to do, is help keep track of the things that you can't keep track of. The idea is so that you're able to focus on the important parts of your business, getting the clients, you know, recording the work, mixing, you know, whatever your part of doing this business is, that's what you need to do, is rely on them to do that. That's one of the things you'll find as a businessman when you have a business of your own. You can't do it all. You have to trust people. And the key to that is getting people, hiring and working with the right people.